We're in New York.
Right.
I flew in last night, so I'm feeling a little bit... but not too bad from LA. So we're doing... This is for the DVD.
Right.
For Imagine Me and You.
But the rest of the interviews are for what?
I don't know. I mean, I just sit here and people come in and you chat.
What have they been asking you?
Ooh, they've been asked, do you believe in love at first sight? Is the gay, all about the gay thing, which I think they're going over the top with about, you know, is Hollywood, is this a new genre of movies? And it's like, not really. No, it just happens that a few films have come out and they share a similar theme and they don't really share necessarily even that. I don't know. Do you know what I mean? So, yeah, they're interested in that, and obviously they're interested in the beautiful girls within the film.
Right.
So.
Well, I will go back and ask some of the questions you've probably already been asked, but when you first read the script, what was your take on Heck?
I liked it. I thought he had a very interesting arc throughout the film. You know, he's not a nasty person. You know, I think he's deeply in love with the girl. It's definitely more of a best friend relationship. But as far as he's concerned, you know, this is the woman that he's going to spend the rest of his life with. And rather than him being, you know, saying like nasty and making it easier for the girls to get together, making it easier for the audience to, you know. I mean, it's like you sympathize with Heck throughout, which is a much more interesting way of doing it, rather than him being, I say, this nasty guy who then the girls get together and he's just an asshole and he's off. So, I think it's quite an intelligently written film. I don't think I certainly haven't seen anything that's sort of like this, you know, with another girl getting together with another girl and it's not really being an issue. It's just a story about love, really.